And apparently it didn't work.
So I'm gonna get started. I found my lump.
The first lump, I found my lump in 2019, like in July, August.
So we're in there.
I can't remember the exact month and date that it was when I found it, but I found it. I went to my doctor at that time, my PCP, my primary care physician, and
he tried to throw it off.
It's just a mass, a mass being like a bump or some liquid that'll eventually go away.
Like a bottle
liquid.
As far as this phone,
I'm also recording on here for Facebook live. So, but yeah, he told me it would go away,
and it was nothing
to worry about since I was 25. In which,
you know, it still
should have been something to look at, but he didn't.
It's
bothering me.
It's bothering me.
So bad. But he didn't.
So, you know, I kind of
like, I trusted him. He's a doctor, so I trusted him, and
I went home
and I let it go for a few months.
Oh, Lord forgive me.
I'm sorry.
So,
after a few months, like during those few months that I let it go, I noticed it was becoming painful and that it was big.
But bigger than what it started
off being. So I kind of questioned it at first.
It wasn't like a big
deal, because it only grew bigger first, and then later on, down the line, it got painful. So once it started getting painful, I knew something wasn't right. So somewhere in March, so I was diagnosed on March 12th. So somewhere in March, late February, early March, I returned back to my primary care and explained to him what was going on, about it getting bigger, about it being painful to me, to the touch. Even when I wasn't touching it,
it was sitting like,
I would have sharp pain through that one breast. So, you know, I knew at that time something wasn't right for sure.
So around
after that time, he had sent me over to the hospital to get some testing done, and then once I got that testing done, he referred me to my surgeon. My surgeon is actually Dr. Anthony Abraham in El Dorado. He's a wonderful surgeon. He
would like to see you on
a brother-sister level than he does anything else.
He's great. He's definitely great.
But, and he had more scans done on me.
After that, I
had to do an MRI. I had to
get, I want to say it was a CAT
scan. I'm not quite sure, but I know it was a scan done. And then I had to get
a biopsy.
Biopsy is when they numb this area and they stick this
long needle,
extremely long needle, through the skin into the tumor or lump or whatever. And they draw fluid from it.
It's really weird how they did it.
It's like kind of like a shooting gun that gets the
tissue and the fluid from the lung.
So it was a weird experience, and I'm pretty sure that if you've had a biopsy done, then you know exactly what I'm talking about. But
he had a biopsy done on a lung,
and after about a few days of, you know, everything going through its cycle and getting results back, his nurse called me around somewhere around the 9th and the 11th of March and told me to come in.
And when they told me to come
in, it's like my heart literally just
stopped.
Completely stopped.
It's no other way that I can
explain it, really. It's my heart just dropped because I knew that me getting that call and them telling me to come in instead of me getting that call and them telling me everything was okay for my scans, me getting that call and them telling me to come in is what
broke my heart.
Like, I knew that something was going wrong. I didn't know what, and I didn't know to what extent, but I just knew that something was going wrong. Make sure when you come in that you like and share this video, please.
I knew something wrong.
Going on. So, one second. Hold on, y'all. Okay, I'm back.
But,
yeah. That's what I was saying. So, I went in to the office. I want to say it was the next day. That's why I said the 9th through the 11th. Because
I think it was the next day that
I actually went up there. When they called me, it was late, or whatever the case may be. But
I went up there,
and I took my, at the time, best friend, male best friend. I took him with me, or I had him take me. And I went up there, and they set us in the room. We sat there for like 10-15 minutes before Dr. Abraham came in, and once he came in, I could see by the look on his face that, you know, whatever news I was about to get was not the news that I was expecting.
So,
he came in and he sat down, and
the first words
out of his mouth was,
"I'm sorry, Tiffany, but your results came back and you have breast cancer." And honestly, I'm sitting there, and it's like when he said
breast cancer, it in the movies, like, you know how they say a word and it just echoes and that person is just sitting there like lost while that word is echoing? That's exactly how I feel. Except for, not only was I just sitting there while breast cancer echoed through my head, I was crying.
And it was a type of crying
to where I couldn't look at my then male best friend, I couldn't look at the nurse, and I couldn't look at Dr. Abraham.
I was just
stuck.
And so many
thoughts went through my head. So many thoughts went through my head.
But one thing
that stuck
with me was you have a son. That nobody else can raise better than you would raise him. And that's what stuck with me. I'm not going to apologize for the tears because y'all giving this raw and real. This is a side of it that you don't see. And in order for me to be a testimony, you have to see every single side of it. But that's the only thing that stuck. It was because I knew my son was going to need his mama. I knew it exactly.
Doctor, after we talked for a while, I thanked the doctor, and we left. We went back to my mama's house. I want to say I called my mom on the way to her house. It's really all a blur because of the chemo treatments, and we'll get to that too. The chemo treatments, the whole thing messes with your memory, messes with your brain.
So it's really all a blur. That's
why I have this to kind of guide me. But I do remember pulling up to my mom and telling her to come outside. Because I didn't want Key to see me like that. Unless Key might have been still in
school. But I told her to come outside.
And I just
lay in my mom's arms and I just cried.
In my mind, I was too young
to
even go through breast cancer. And it's
true.
Even
women who are under 35,
which is
the date, the year that you're supposed to start doing your mammogram.
Anybody under 35 is too young in my eyes to have breast cancer.
Because we're not supposed to be worried about things like that.
But
reality sets in, and breast cancer is going to hit wherever it wants to hit, whenever it wants to hit, no matter what age.
And then breast cancer, period. It's not even just breast
cancer, so. I don't have COVID.
I just got sinuses. So, make the long story short, I did 4 rounds of AC chemo, which is the
one that they call
the Red Devil. Now, the raw and real on that, I'm not going to sugarcoat on that because this stuff is no joke. That was when I lost the majority of my weight before the weight gain because I couldn't eat. I couldn't eat because I was nauseous all the time. At least 3 to 4 days after the chemo itself. So I could not eat.
And then,
not only was I nauseous, like I had this weird, thankfully my symptoms came before COVID got so deep.
But
not only was I nauseous, my taste buds were off. I wouldn't say I couldn't taste anything. It's just that everything that I was tasting tasted disgusting. I mean, I can't sugarcoat this to y'all. It's like, I cannot sugarcoat this to y'all. Like, it was absolutely disgusting. So that was part of it. And then I was weak, as like muscle wise, I was weak, and I was tired. Either mama had to come over and stay for 2 nights to watch Key, or either he went over there, you know, with her, or we both went over there with her, but I couldn't even watch my own son. I was sleeping majority of the time. I couldn't pick him up, and at that time he was that baby, so. And I'm not saying like the baby, but he was that baby that wanted to be in your arms all the time. So I couldn't do it. But I couldn't eat. But other than that was pretty much all I had to deal with the AC. And then after the AC, I had to do 12 rounds of Taxol. It was a lot lighter than the first 4 rounds of chemo. It was a lot lighter. Only thing I dealt with was nausea and insomnia. The nausea was not as bad. I could still eat. Just every now and then I feel sick off of it. I hurry up, take my medicine, and then it's over with. I finished
all chemo on
October 13th of this year, of course. October 13th. So it's been 2 weeks yesterday that I have been chemo free. Not cancer free, but chemo free. I have to remind everybody that it is a difference because they think that since I'm done with chemo, I have officially beat cancer and I am now cancer free. That is not the case. The case is that I am chemo free. Therefore, I am done with chemo. I no longer have to worry about getting another set of chemo treatments or chemotherapy. None of that. Now, what I might have to do, he actually said I have to do. What I have to go through is I have to go through radiation. Hopefully, we can talk about that because I really don't want to. Because one, the skin burns, and I don't want to go through that. Like, I've already been through enough. I've already been through enough. Not being able to take care of your child because you are too sick. That's the real deal pain. And I know it's the person on my line right now that can agree because she's still watching. I see the green dot. You don't have to say anything. Just know, I know that we can agree with each other on that. That's painful. That is heartbreaking. Laying in the bed, not being able to eat, not being able to almost take care of yourself, that is heartbreaking. You're 25 years old. That's what I was telling myself, like, this is not right. So I've already been through enough. I don't want to go through more skin burns. It's already been enough for 6 weeks. I'm about to be back to being a vegetable, just about. Plaster says she only wants me to bathe myself and brush my teeth. Anything outside of that, do not do. So with that being said, I'm still going through. But yeah, I'm still fighting. Because every time I call my mama, there's a little boy in the background that is saying, "Mama, I want to talk to mama." And that is what keeps me going. And no, for you nosy people on Facebook, YouTube, take a second. For you nosy people on Facebook, yes, I moved. No, my son is not with me. But what you fail to realize is my son is still in school. I have not found a school over here yet that I can trust. So I would rather leave my son over there with my mom in a school that I can trust than to bring him over here to somebody that's going to end up doing something to him. And then I'm going to end up in jail.
So you can think what you want to think.
Say what you want to say. I'm going to take care of mine, and that's all you need to worry about. And you need to take care of yours. All right, you too. You can come on back in. But yeah. This is all a challenge.
And
you don't see this in
cancer
on a daily basis. A lot of people you see that has cancer, probably no bigger than this water bottle.
That's it. But it's probably no bigger
than this water bottle. So.
Seasonal. Allergies is what
don't get me.
Jesus.
Thank you. Yeah, you see how I just backed the table up into this chair? Like I said, you don't get this in cancer. Not a lot. I look at, like, the beginning of my whole battle. I was, you know, going in looking at women, looking at the women that was already there, and, you know, I was seeing how small they were, and each day that I went in there, I said, that's not going to be me. That's not going to be me.
That's not going to be me. And with the grace of God,
I didn't lose. Might have gained some weight, that I don't like, but I didn't lose. And that's what I was happy about. As you can tell, and this doesn't come with this cold or the seasonal allergy crap that I got, but symptoms that come with the freaking COVID. Some of them also come with the chemo treatments. And that's what I was saying earlier. Thank God my symptoms showed up before COVID-19 started getting
serious.
Because
literally,
almost every symptom that they asked you about, I already had because of the chemo treatment. So, but yeah,
it's more to
this whole thing that you guys know, and you won't know until you see it firsthand. Or you experience it yourself.
When I started
chemo treatments, I had people telling me, don't do those. Don't go through that because that's what killed my cousin. Baby, the cancer is what killed. Okay? Chemo treatment is not what's killing you. It may feel like, are you on your deathbed, but it is not actually killing you. And I can say that now that I've been through it. So stop telling people that. Stop going out there and telling those people that, because that's only scaring the crap out of them. And at that point of their whole battle, they don't need that. Not at that time. They don't need you scaring them. Stop doing it. Try to make sure that's all we got to talk about. I will have a double mastectomy that's having both breasts cut off with both breast tissue removed. They're not going to actually be cut off, but removed. And I'm going to have expanders put in. She's going to fill them up each time that I go back to her. I can't remember exactly how many times that is or when it is exactly. But she's going to fill them up. And then once I get to the size that I want to be, which is kind of like right in here somewhere. But once I get to the size where I want to be, then I'm going to sit with the expanders for 3 months to fully kind of heal. And then she's going to go in and she's going to put in my implant.
And then I'll be finished.
I would have to go back, every 5 or so years to get new implants because just like real boobs, they age too. So you want to kind of keep them fresh. But she did. I wish I would have did this angle with the YouTube.
She did say
that I will be coming back, like, to get new ones. I almost lost my train of thought. Baby, I looked over here at this camera and I saw what was going on and I was like, yeah, I like that. But yeah, she told me that I will be coming back. I've been breaking out.
To get them
kind of, I guess she's going to go in there and swap them out because they age with your body just as well as the real ones do.
I know that's not what I want
because I'm actually glad to be getting rid of these because they have a little slack, saggy, and I like minus it up. So, that has been, I'm sorry I didn't play the music or anything, guys. It's just me talking, which that's what I'm training myself to do. I gotta go attend. I gotta make sure my Wi-Fi is connected back to me, my laptop, because it's not my Wi-Fi, but yeah. Because I need to go attend classes again. But thanks for tuning in. That has been my full breast cancer story. The story that you did not hear on the news. The story that I have not told on social media. I'm giving it to you real and raw. YouTube, be looking for a vlog later on. Not today though. But later on, somewhere down the line, maybe a week or two. Facebook, I'm going to keep doing Motivational Mondays for sure. And I'm going to keep trying to do a middle of the week motivational live. Kind of keep y'all fresh. And as far as weekends go, y'all might have one this weekend. No, let me turn off YouTube real quick. All right, YouTube, signing out.